Dear students, welcome to the video lecture series on vocational electronic science. Our topic is sources of power. This presentation is created and narrated by Hemant Satpute, teacher, Department of Electronic Science, Fergusson College, Junior Wing, Pune 4. In the lecture number 9, we are going to discuss voltage and current sources, DC voltage source and the internal impedance of a voltage source. So let's begin. Voltage and current source. Energy can be stored in inductors and capacitors and it can be dissipated in resistors. These elements are passive elements. We have active elements like batteries and generators which supply energy. Every source of energy supplies both current and voltage. But to understand the difference between voltage and current source, they are studied independently. If the output voltage is completely independent of the current, the source is known as pure voltage source. The output voltage is not affected by the changes in the circuit. It is specified as a function of time. If output current is completely independent of voltage source, voltage across the source, then it is known as a current source. A pure voltage source can supply or absorb any amount of power. Now, this is the symbolic representation of an ideal voltage source. Here, for DC voltage source, this is the symbol of DC voltage source. Across the two terminals, it is providing a voltage Vs. And this is the symbol of AC voltage source. Across the two terminals, it provides Vs. Actually, for AC, there is no positive and negative terminals. So, this is a mistake in this particular symbol. I regret for this mistake. Now, let's see the new concept. Next concept, internal impedance of a source. Every source of electrical energy has some internal impedance, which is also called as internal resistance. This means when a DC source of 1 volt EMF is an open circuit, its potential difference is 1 volt. That is, its internal resistance is 0. But ideally, this does not happen. When same source is connected in a closed circuit of load resistance of some value, the potential difference across the load is less than the applied voltage drop across its internal impedance or internal resistance. This internal impedance may be due to following reasons. Number one, the resistance of the electrolyte between the electrodes in case of a cell. Number two, the resistance of the armature windings in case of an alternator or a DC generator. The internal impedance may be due to the output impedance of the active device like a transistor or a vacuum tube in case of all oscillators or signal generators and rectification type DC supplies. So these are three reasons for a voltage source to have an internal impedance. That's all for today's lecture. Stay tuned for the next lecture in the series. Please do visit my YouTube video channel FYJC Vocational Electronics for all the video lectures on different topics in this series. Please do subscribe, like, share, and stay tuned.